Hello everyone and welcome to a little talk about the Megaluman. First, let's take another look at the power supply. For comparison, this is a quite a good quality Meanwell power supply, 150 watts, and it's tiny. It's a bit bigger than the HP power supply from the Megaluman. These are really, really amazing power supplies for very little money. They are not widely useful for many things, but if you can find an application for this, then of course take them, even if you just don't need such a high power like all the 100 amps. If you just would be taking some 30-40, these are still the best option. And this one is dead. I broke it when I modified, when I was dremeling out the copper around these posts to isolate the output side. I thought I take a shortcut and not dremel around the post, but cut the whole pad. And as it turns out, the main PCB is not a simple double-sided board, it's a multi-layer board, and it appears to be at least four layers, which is just amazing, the level of sophistication in these power supplies. And I've cut straight through the output rectification MOSFETs gate drives. So this power supply is well and truly busted. So I would probably keep it for some real in-depth teardown, which could be very, very interesting because of the unusual technology in this. Another mode that I didn't talk about in the main videos, I've cut a pieces of a copper plate and bend it around the edge connector and soldered the bottom and the top, because when I was soldering the wires, I was always soldering just to one side, and I wanted the power to be taken out of both sides of the PCB, just as it was designed. So I soldered these pieces of copper plate to it. All right, this is about the power supply. Next thing, about the stuff that connects the power supply to the LEDs. The main thing in it is this little IC. It's just amazing. If you have to drive a bit more MOSFETs and you want to drive them properly, you need something like this. This is an isolated MOSFET gate driver with a peak output current up to 2.5 amps. It has a threshold value on the input current to the optocoupler LED. It has undervoltage protection. It does everything for you regarding the driving of the gates of the MOSFETs. The final schematic of the switching of the switching component is something like this. On the input you have a resistor to load the input down, then there is a little LED to indicate that the current is going in. In series there is a tiny little IC which is a 2-pin current source. This thing is a variable resistor, and it always passes some set current. This one is at 13 milliamps, which is just great for the input of the TLP IC, and this combination handles the input signal. On the output side, you have the power supply connected to 12 volts, which is just fine. There is a 100 nanofarad capacitor, and the output goes through a 10 ohm resistor. This resistor is really important, and you have to get the value right, because if you choose a too small value, the gates would be charged too quickly, and it will lead to a quick ending of the MOSFET. MOSFET gates. Yeah. The way you think about it is something like, if the output is switched to the 12 volts, there is 0 volts on the MOSFETs. What is the current? In this case, it's 1.2 amps, which is just enough, because we are not driving these MOSFETs at very high frequencies. If we would be at some crazy 200 kilohertz or something like this, we will have to have a more powerful drive circuit and less resistance in here. The MOSFETs, there are some IRF MOSFETs. You of course choose a MOSFET you need for the application. There are 4 of them. It's some type with the R drain source on about 5 milliohms, so really great MOSFETs, and they form the output minus pole, and the megalumen LED goes between this and the plus from the main power supply. It's just a really simple circuitry, and it works really well. It switches the MOSFETs quite fast, and they emit almost no heat. A bit more about the how the megalumen current and working powers are set. It's really simple. I use the connecting wire as a resistor, and the way you think about it is, I have measured the modules at the main current, and I know that I need some 99.4 volts at the megalumen fixture for the full half 5 kilowatts, and you take the current, and then you simply add a estimated resistance of this switching circuitry, of the wires and the main connecting wire, and then add it up all together, and I was very happy that I aimed for 33 amps, and it went exactly at 33 amps. I've calculated the resistance needed, and I calculated how long wire of a given cross section I need, and that's how long I made this wire, and it worked just perfect. The current was set just how I needed it. So this is about the little things, and now we're going to take a look at how the megalumen project looks right now. Right, this is how the megalumen project looks like now. It lives in this very nice custom-made flight case. It was made to specific dimensions to fit the fixtures perfectly. It's a great quality and it wasn't that expensive. Four handles, nice wheels, and all around great quality. And inside there is lots of stuff. In here sits the power supply. Here is the fixture. It's fixed in like these holders. You just take it up vertically and it's in there nice and safe. And inside, because I have just one fixture, but there is really room for two. There are the bubble machines right under here. They have been modified extensively and also painted black to be less obvious on the stage. There are some speaker wires. There is a lots of bubble and snow fluids. And in here is the wire that connects the power supply and the fixture. All right, this is the current state of the Megalomania project. Thank you for watching and goodbye.